name is Deepak. I live in Allentown. So these are the Lego buildings that I've done. So I have always been fascinated by skyscrapers and basically the history of how the skyscrapers came about. And as we know, the skyscrapers, the earliest ones all, I guess, started being built in New York. So I took New York as my inspiration. And so the buildings I've done are all from New York. So this one is the 70 Pine Street, which is one of the skyscrapers built during the golden era of skyscrapers, which is the early Depression era when we had a real boom in the skyscrapers. So many of the most well-known skyscrapers were built during that period. So I just did the ones that were the most famous and ended up being the tallest ones. So this is the 70 Pine Street. This is the 40 Wall Street, which is now called the Trump Building. And this is, of course, the Chrysler Building and the Empire State Building, which I guess everyone knows. Yes. Yeah.
You got some more, some of the more famous ones. So do all four of these buildings still exist then?
Yes, they do all exist.
Okay.
So these two are in Lower Manhattan, and they're actually almost right next to each other. So they're both on Pine Street. And these two are in Midtown.
Yeah. So when you first start, you know, stylistically, these are very similar in the way you build them. So mm-hmm. when you first start with a building design, what's that process like for you? How do you start one of these?
What I do is I just study the building in Google Earth. And one nice thing about Google Earth is it lets you make measurements. So I actually sketch out the plan for the building on paper using like graph paper. And since these were all built during a period where the buildings had a tapered shape because of the zoning, I guess, regulations they had back then.
So it's wider at the bottom.
It's wider at the bottom. So the issue was that back then, all these buildings were rising up and they were blocking out too much sunlight and air from the streets below. So they put in place these restrictions where you had to have a tapered shape, and so all of these have the setbacks, as you can see. So I actually draw these out on paper and figure out what the different sections are going to be and how much of a setback I need, and then I figure out the number of pieces I would need for each section. And in cases where the setback is too much and I would need some kind of internal support, I actually build walls inside of the buildings that you cannot see. So I end up just getting the cheapest pieces that you can get, like in pink or yellow or whatever. And then I create internal walls that support these setbacks.
Some of the nice little filler brick in there.
Yes.
So I love how you do this, because there's very little to no studs showing on these. So yes. Talk about your approach to that and like tiling and how you make these look from the outside.
Yeah, I'm not a huge fan of, I know there's different schools of thought. Some like to have stud showing, but I like to have a smooth appearance as much as possible. So people don't realize that it's made of Lego at first glance. So of course I kind of use tiles to hide all of the studs that are showing. And yeah, that's pretty much it. So I try to just avoid having any studs on the outside.
And when you build these, do you build them in sections so you can move them easier?
Yes. So I create seams between the different sections that I can hide quite easily. And again, it depends on the kind of, building style I use. So there's like two different types depending on the scale that I use. So here I have like bricks sandwiched with like two plates. So when you have two plates, it's easy to create a seam between the plates and... that way, yeah, it's easy to just lift the section off and easy to transport it, of course.
Right, that makes it easy. Do you take these out around to a lot of shows?
No, actually, I started in this hobby like less than 2 years ago.
Oh.
So I just built these one after the other, and this is the very first show I've been to.
Wow, well, that's amazing. This is very impressive work. I'm so glad you could bring them out.
Thank you.
Do you have a favorite of these four here so far that you've done?
Yeah, actually, the 70 Pine Street ended up being the most challenging one for me because of all the setbacks, as you can see. it's got a really complicated, I guess, massing. So it took me a lot of, work to figure out how to map the dimensions of the actual building into Lego. And just given all the challenges that I had with that, it's my favorite, because I think it turned out really well after all the work I put in.
Right, there's so many different layers there that you've got to work with.
Yes.
So, do you have plans to add more buildings in the future and kind of keep with this theme?
I was thinking of maybe extending this to a few more buildings from the same time period, maybe the Woolworth, but that one is pretty challenging. So yeah, I may end up doing that at some point.
Yeah, hopefully, because I love what you've done so far here, and it looks like you even have kind of notebooks set out. Is that information about each building?
Yes, so I actually thought it might be handy to have some information on just the history of the skyscrapers. So just I put together some slides to describe just the history of all the skyscrapers, and of course the buildings you see here are part of that history, so you will see them on some of these pages. So this one is the 40 Wall Street. So this was the first of the four that ended up being the tallest building at one point.
Yeah, you're trying to make it an educational experience for people as well when they see these.
Yes. Yeah, I think these are some of the older buildings that people may not know, so I just wanted people to get an appreciation for the history of these buildings.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much for bringing these out, and I'm so glad you can make it to your first show here. What's your experience been like so far?
It's been great, yeah. It was nice getting a lot of feedback from people, and people asking questions about how I did the builds. So yeah, it was pretty interesting experience.
Nice. So you'll be back then, hopefully.
Yes, I'm hoping to attend more shows in the future, yes.
Fantastic. Thank you so much for taking us through the buildings. I appreciate it.
Thanks a lot.